This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book The Big Fix. Author, Richard Wilson. Year, 1956. Topic, The Big Fix. I read about a drug called Yage. Maybe I will find in Yage what I was looking for in junk and weed and coke. Yage may be the final fix, William Lee Junkie. 1. Was meeting the man in a cafeteria on West End Avenue, the rundown part of the avenue south of 72nd Street, where all the garages and auto parts places are. I didn't need a fix. I'd been off the junk for 3 months, and I was all right. I was drinking a lot, but that was all. The meet in the cafeteria was set up by an old connection of mine who'd heard I was interested in this new stuff. My connection's name was Rollo, sometimes called Rollo the Roller because he rolled lushes in the subway. Rollo and I had coffee while we waited for the man. "He's a funny one," Rollo said. "Not like any other pusher I ever dig." "You sure he's straight?" I asked. "He wouldn't be one of the people, would he?" "Nah, he's no agent. Don't you think I can make a cop or a federal by now?" "All right. I wasn't trying to insult you." We sipped our coffee and talked in low voices. The cafeteria wasn't a regular joint. It might be in time, and then it would be one till it got too hot, but it wasn't now. I didn't see the guy come in. The first thing I knew, he was standing at the table over us. Tall, wearing a black suit like an undertaker or a preacher, but with a dark blue shirt and a white tie. He had a young old face, and his skin was a light tan. Not the tan you get at Miami Beach or from a sun lamp, but as if he had Chinese or Malay blood in him somewhere. Rollo jumped a little when he noticed him at his elbow. "Oh, hello, Jones. Creeping up on people again. Sit down. This is Barry." I acknowledged the introduction. I was sure Jones wasn't his real name any more than Barry was mine. I asked him if I could buy him a cup of coffee, and he said no, and then Rollo left. Rollo mumbled something about business, but I got the feeling he didn't like being around Jones any more than he had to. "I understand you are interested in my product," Jones said. He had dark brown eyes, almost black. He didn't talk like a pusher, but you can't always make generalizations. "I don't want to score any," I said. "At least not right now. I'm off the stuff, but I take a sort of philosophical interest in it, you might say." "I could not sell you any at the moment in any case," Jones said. "I do not make a practice of carrying it on my person." "Of course not. But what is it?" "Rollo tells me it's not the usual junk. I wondered if maybe it was Yage." "Yage was something you kept hearing about, but never saw yourself. It was always somebody who knew somebody else who tried it. Yage was the junkie's dream. You never caught up with it, but you heard hints in conversation. An addict would give himself a fix of Henry, sliding the needle into the vein, and later, as his tension relaxed, he'd say to his connection, "I hear Yage is the real kick. They tell me that compared to Yage, heroin is the least." And the connection would say, "That's what they tell me, but I never seen any of it myself. They have it in the Amazon or someplace, I hear. It's always hearsay. But after a while, you hear so much about it that you believe it's got to be around somewhere, so you keep asking." I asked Jones. "I could show you Yage," Jones said, and I felt a tingle like a kid promised his first kiss. "But it would disappoint you." "Why?" "It is like peyote, just another herb. It has a similar effect to that of the mezcal cactus button, but since you would not seem to be a devotee of the sun dance, I do not think it would interest you." I went into a slump again when I heard him run down Yage. I knew what peyote was. It might be all right for Indians, but it just made the average junkie sick to his stomach. "What would interest me then?" I asked him. "I have a certain amount of a substance called uru," he said. "It is, and I do not exaggerate when I say this, the most. I couldn't help grinning. Jones had been speaking the store-bought English of the educated foreigner, and then he came out with this hep expression. "Tell me more, Professor," I said. "You're ringing my bell." "You tell me more, my friend," he came back. "What is your great interest in this will-o'-the-wisp yage that so excites you?"
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.